You're watching Minity Maths. This video provides a range of practice GCSE Maths questions and answers. Subscribe and hit the notification bell for weekly videos. Let's look at this first exam style question about bearings. This question requires you to accurately draw the position of a third car, C, on the diagram. This means you will need to use a protractor. Let's use the information given in the first sentence to draw a line from car A to where car C could be. First, we should use our protractor to measure an angle of 60 degrees clockwise from the north line of car A. From this point, draw a line and extend as far as you can. We know the car will be somewhere along this line, but we can't be sure just yet exactly what point on the line the car will be. Now we repeat this for the information given in the second sentence. Remember to measure the angle clockwise. So the point where these two lines meet is the exact position of car C. We can mark this on the diagram. In the exam, do not rub out your lines, as these will be used to show how you worked out the position and gain full marks. This next set of questions involves solving equations. With question 1, there are two ways we can solve this. We can either expand the brackets or rearrange. Let's look at how we can rearrange this equation before solving. Firstly, we can remove the 5 outside of the brackets by dividing both sides by 5. We can then add 3 to each side to cancel out the minus 3 and get f on its own. For question 2, let's see how we can solve this by using the expanding brackets method. Firstly, we should multiply each term inside the brackets by 4, to get rid of the brackets. We only do this to the side with the brackets. Then we can add 8 to both sides, leaving us with the equation 20w equals 56. Next, we can divide both sides by 20. For the third question, we need to rearrange the equation to get all terms in H on one side and all the constant terms on the other side. Firstly, let's move 2h to the other side of the equals sign, remembering to change the sign from a plus to a minus. We can then move the 3 to the right side, making it a minus 3. Next, we can simplify. The final question involves a power, but firstly we should get rid of the 5, by taking away 5 from both sides of the equation. We are then left with the equation d squared equals 25. We then take the square root of both sides to find out what d equals. This next question relates to rotational symmetry. In an exam, you can use tracing paper for this part. We are told that the square has rotational symmetry of order 4. This means that when we rotate the square through 360 degrees, it will look identical 4 times. The question asks us to place 2 dots onto the square to give it a rotational symmetry of 2, instead of 4. Let's try placing 2 dots on the square, at diagonally opposite corners. We can then draw out a copy of the diagram in order to rotate and compare to the original. This is easier to do if you have tracing paper. It's also a good idea to keep a tally of how many times the square looks the same when it is rotated through 360 degrees. As you can see, the diagram now only looks identical two times when rotated 360 degrees. Therefore, it has a rotational symmetry order of 2, satisfying the statement in the question. For the third question, we are asked to work out the surface area of the 3D shape by using its net. As we have three rectangular faces and two triangular faces, we can work these out individually first, then add them all together to find the total area. It may help to watch our video about compound shapes, linked above, if you need a recap. So, let's start with finding the area of one triangular face first. The formula for finding the area of a triangle is half times base times height. In the diagram, we are given the length of the base, 2 cm, and the perpendicular height of the triangle, 3 cm. We can now calculate the area of the triangular face. Because the net contains two triangular faces, we can multiply our answer by 2 to find the area of both. Let's make a note of this and move on to finding the area of the rectangular faces. To find the area of a rectangle, we just need to multiply the length by the width. In this case, we multiply the length of 7 cm by the width of 2 cm. As there are 3 rectangular faces, we can multiply our answer by 3 to find the total area of all 3 rectangles. Now that we have found the area for the triangular and the rectangular faces, we can add these together to find the total area of the net, which in turn provides us with the surface area of the 3D shape. This question is worth 3 marks. One mark will be awarded for finding the area of the triangular faces, one mark for the area of the rectangular faces, and the third mark for finding the total surface area of the shape. Thanks for watching Minity Maths. Good luck in the exams.